Well, I hope you all are still doing well. Before we get into this video, I want to read a tweet, and this tweet is by Rob Schneider, who you know is a comedic actor, and he exemplified in this tweet exactly how I'm feeling, minus the being born and growing up here. But he is one of many that is fleeing Los Angeles and California to go to a different state. And this is what he wrote. And Rob, I would imagine, is a very liberal person. I don't really know his politics, but I'm going to guess. But he says this. He said, "California, land of my birth and where all of my children were born, I've spent all of my life in your beauty. Surfing your waves on warm summer days, rode motorcycles on your gorgeous coastline, lived, loved, and laughed in your beautiful cities, enjoyed your wines of perfection. So it is with much sadness that we have to part, but it is time to leave. Hashtag California, you broke my heart." And that is how I feel about California at this time. And I know I still live in LA. And again, I'm keeping my options open. I have hope, but every day that hope gets a little tinier and a little tinier and a little tinier. And with our new DA of Los Angeles County, it has dwindled to just about here. Our new DA, whom I did not vote for, his name is George Gascon. And he was sworn into office on Monday. Within 10 minutes, he issued a long directive, and we're going to get into that in just a second. But first, who is this person? I didn't know much about him until this week when I started looking into him. Again, I did not vote for this man. But George Gascon was the former DA in San Francisco. When you look at what happened during his term in San Francisco and what's happening now, it's very interesting. Under his leadership, he did some of the same things and had some of the same directives that he is implementing here in Los Angeles. Under his leadership, out of 141 people that worked for him, 60 of those people quit. Under his leadership in San Francisco was the third highest in violent crime, the highest in property crime, yet they were one of the lowest in arrest. I want to read you a little piece of an op-ed, and this was written by a woman named Nancy Tung, and she was an attorney that actually worked in San Francisco under his leadership, who also quit under his leadership, and she had this to say. So she says, "Los Angeles, take a look at the state Gascon left San Francisco as a cautionary tale. It's no wonder he didn't seek re-election in the county where he was an incumbent. It's because he could never win another term here. He left this city in such shambles that even San Francisco's mayor and city attorney took the unusual step of endorsing his competitor, incumbent Jackie Lacey." So that's who he ran against here in Los Angeles. So his former mayor, who was that? And city attorney endorsed Jackie and not him. That's pretty crazy. "George Gascon wreaked havoc on the San Francisco DA's office and the city as a whole. I just hope he doesn't get an opportunity to ruin Los Angeles as well." Well, fast forward to Monday when he was sworn in. After being in office for only 2 hours, he released this lengthy list of directives for Los Angeles. And basically what it says is this. So I'm going to summarize it. And this is Bill from Fox LA. He put a list together to make it a little bit faster. So here's basically the summary of what it says. New, LA County DA George Gascon has issued a directive to prosecutors that the following misdemeanors will be declined for prosecution with exemptions: trespassing, disturbing the peace, driving without a license, prostitution, resisting arrest, criminal threats, drug possession, minor with alcohol, drinking in public under the influence of a controlled substance, public intoxicating, loitering. He also wants to end cash bail and end the death penalty. Here's a few clips that I pulled of him talking about this from the Tucker Carlson show. Tucker Carlson did a really good segment on this tonight, but here's a few short clips of him talking about this.
Largely associated with poverty. Loitering, drinking in public, public intoxication, racism and the death penalty in our country are inextricably intertwined.
What's even more disturbing about this, other than the obvious, and we will get to that, believe me, what's even more disturbing about this is the fact that for years, Californians have over and over and over again voted against ending the death penalty. And just in our November 3rd general elections, they had Proposition 25 was on our ballot. We voted not to end cash bail. So we voted against this. His first 2 hours in office, he is going against what the people of California have historically and just recently voted against. What you're thinking? Well, you're probably not thinking that because it's California, but if it were any other place, I know what you're thinking. How could this happen? How could someone be voted in that is clearly against what the people want? And obviously he doesn't care what the people want. He must think he's smarter than the people because he's going against what the people voted for. So you must be thinking, well, how could this person get in office? How could the people of California vote this person in office? Could it be because maybe George Soros put over $2 million in his campaign? Could it be that our celebrities are backing his campaign? I found this on Twitter. John Legend, George Gascon, our new DA in Los Angeles, just announced some major reforms on his first day. Proud to have supported his election. This is the kind of change we voted for and the kind of change we need to bring our system closer to true justice. John Legend, who lives in a $17.5 million house in Beverly Hills, which I'm imagining has a really big gate around it. And I don't know if you know anything about the Beverly Hills police officers. They don't play. So John Legend is living in an area that is super protected. Their police are super tight and in a huge home, probably be behind a giant gate, and has the money to hire his own private security, is pushing for this. Another disturbing angle of all of this is he uses poverty as a reason why you can't prosecute these low-level crimes, which, first of all, is the bigotry of low expectations. You're saying that if you're poor, then you're not able to follow the law. I'm going to read you a few text messages from some attorneys that work under him. They asked to be anonymous because they don't want retribution. This is from the LAist. You can find these at a few other places. So it says, Gascon met with his staff Monday, and afterwards some prosecutors were upset. All hell has seriously broken out, read one text exchange. Another person said, he is not interested in public safety, but in the defendant's best interest. He is not welcomed. Another one said, our new DA has turned this office into a public defender's office. This office is in an uproar. I am definitely retiring in 1.5 years. This is gonna destroy Los Angeles. We are the second largest city in the US. And he brings up poverty as a reason to not have bail, saying that it's unfair. Well, that's the whole point of bail being set, so you kind of can't pay it. Why do you think some people have bail that's set at millions of dollars? It's designed that way for a reason. Taking away every deterrent, even in these low-level crimes, what incentive do people have not to commit crimes? And criminals talk. They know things. They go to the areas where they know they can get away with things. On the night of May 31st, when we had our mass looting that was going on, it was going on all over LA County. It was Hollywood, Beverly Hills, West Hollywood, Santa Monica, Hermosa Beach, Manhattan Beach. They were going everywhere all in one night to go and hit up places. Why do you think they were doing that? Because they knew that the cops were overwhelmed and that nothing was going to happen. There was this small little bodega that got hit up in, I believe it was Hermosa Beach. I have a really good friend that lives there. And they hit it up on May 31st. Well, they came back again in a few weeks and hit that same place up the same way. Why do you think they did that? Because they realized how easy it was to break in and then nothing happened. That's why they did it. Venice Beach has an insane homeless population. Most of those people that are homeless in Venice Beach, they're not from Venice Beach. Why is that? Because they know it's easy. No one's going to bother them in Venice Beach. They can do their drugs. They can put up tents. They can do whatever they want. So they flock to Venice Beach. And who suffers? Well, everyone suffers. Homelessness is a very sad thing, and I have a lot of compassion for those people, but it's a layered and complicated problem. But also, the law-abiding citizens that pay their taxes, that want to raise their families, those are the people that suffer as well. I can't tell you how many times I've walked around Venice Beach and I'll see a mom with a little young child, and then there's a man who's shirtless and all drugged out, just screaming at nothing right beside them, and they're just minding their own business because they're used to it. It's normal now. And during all this, you don't hear him talking about victims. We seem to be having all these conversations about people committing crimes that are going out and committing these crimes, yet we don't talk about the victims. What about the victims? What about them? A few people that work for LA actually had some things to say about this. So this is the Los Angeles Protective League, a union that represents rank-and-file officers, criticized the new policies on Monday. They say, as homicides, shooting victims, and shots fired into occupied homes soar in Los Angeles, it's disturbing that Gascon's first act in office is to explore every avenue possible to release from jail those responsible for this bloodshed. These victims and law-abiding residents lost a voice today, while criminal and gang members gained an ally in the prosecutor's office. And just on a personal note, everything that I've seen in LA, and I know what all you're going to say, you still live there, get out. We'll see what happens with that. As somebody who's seen what's happened in LA, even before the pandemic hit, seeing the homelessness increase, and then everything that happened the past few months, the rioting, the protesting, as a law-abiding, tax-paying citizen, you feel increasingly powerless, and you know who is favored. It's not people like me that pay my taxes, go to work hard, try to be a good member of the community, try to help other people. I volunteer, all kinds of stuff. People like me are not heard anymore. It is now the people that are stomping through your town, breaking stuff, yelling, screaming, committing crimes. Those are the people that now have the power, not the victims, not the law-abiding people. You know, I grew up pretty poor. You could say we were at that level. When my mom divorced my dad, she was working 7 days a week. We lived in a small, tiny apartment, could barely pay the bills. She literally knew when to write a check and how many days she had to make sure the money was in the account, so she would play with it. Sometimes at the grocery store, she'd write checks for money that was not in her account yet, or she would pay bills. But she knew, okay, the check will clear in this amount of days. So I know what it's like to be poor, and we weren't out committing crimes. There was a lot of crimes that happened in my neighborhood. No one was out committing crimes. I used to work in the projects. I worked with underprivileged kids, and they are very capable of not committing crimes. And I always say, you know, wherever you set the bar, people will meet it. You set it down here, people will meet it down here. You set it up here, people will meet it up here. How Mayor Giuliani cleaned up New York was starting to prosecute those low-level crimes. I could go on about this forever. I don't even know if I'm making sense anymore, but let me know what you guys think. I have a feeling I already know. It's a sad day for Los Angeles. We'll see what happens with this. All right, thank you guys. Bye.